Hey, who's in charge here?
Yes, officer. What seems to be the problem?
You need a permit for this. You gotta stop right now unless you get one.
Oh, I have a permit. It explicitly allows a team of students from the University of Minnesota and Marshall University to do some exploratory excavation here.
Let's see here. And your name?
Professor Carl Benford, University of Minnesota Archaeology Department. I'm in charge of this operation.
This permit from the Chippewa tribe. You need one from the city.
Excuse me, officer, but they do not. I am the chief of the Chippewa tribe near here. The Treaty of 1875 between the United States government and native tribes in the state of Minnesota says all native soil is under the jurisdiction of the local tribes. No national, state, or local U.S. government authority.
This ain't no native reservation.
According to the treaty, it also includes all native burial grounds.
Well, this ain't no native burial ground neither.
Oh, really? That was not what I was told a year ago.
And you are?
Dr. Benjamin Maxwell, Marshall University. I represent the students from there. You ought to remember me. You escorted me to my car.
I did? Okay, y'all gotta hold up work until I check with the mayor.
Very well.
Okay, team, hold up for a bit and take a break. We have some administrative items to clear up.
You again! I thought I told you...
You told me this was a native burial ground. Well, it turns out I only needed to contact the local tribe to obtain permission for an excavation.
I made a mistake. You gotta get a permit. This isn't a native burial ground.
Oh? Then what exactly is buried here? Surely there must be some public record of it.
That's none of your business.
I believe it is our business, Mr. Mayor. My name is Theodore Arctis, and I represent the International Organization of Color Bears. And we have evidence that suggests that these mounds hold the remains of an entire colony of color bears, brutally massacred in 1933.
You can't know that. Nobody knows what's buried here, if anything.
Then how do you know that it isn't a native burial mound?
Like you told me it was.
You can't stop us, Mr. Mayor. I know how government bureaucracies work, and you are in a no-win situation. Either these are native burial mounds and we keep digging, or they aren't, and we bring in an historical forensics team to finish the job. We've already applied for that permit with the state, and they don't play the same games you do, Mayor, especially when it comes to the slaughter of innocent civilians. One way or another, these mounds will be excavated. And if you attempt to interfere, not only will we make sure the public knows about what you already know we'll find here, but we'll also make damn sure they know who's been responsible for covering it up for nearly a century.
I highly recommend you let us continue, Mayor. We're willing to be discreet and keep this out of the headlines. Continue to stonewall, and the press will have a field day here with the evidence we already have.
So, Mr. Mayor, what's the official word? Are these native burial mounds, or are they not? Well, we're waiting.
Let's get out of here, Lenny. Leave them to excavate these native mounds in peace.
But, Mayor!
I said, let's go! For the record, I don't know anything about these mounds.
All right, you're free to continue.
I was there as well, although I didn't have to say a word. Both Dr. Maxwell and Mayor Arctis asked me to come as a witness. I admit, it was very hard to watch their progress, as the mere thought of the massacre made me feel ill. Once we knew that the town would not interfere, work went faster. We found well over 200 remains. All but two were Ursus Chromata. The other two that weren't were hybrids. Both infants. When I was told that, I wept. Yes, it was nearly a century ago, but I could not help but imagine how I would feel if they had been Corona. and Perseus. We negotiated with the town regarding reburying the remains properly, and they seemed quite eager to help once they knew that they themselves would not be blamed. Yes, they maintained the cover-up, but those actually guilty were already dead. A sign of contrition would suffice. That, and the money to at least let them be buried with a headstone, even if it was blank. The town also agreed to have a monument to the atrocity erected in the center. All that was expensive, but the crowdfunding the town did for it brought them more than half of the money they would need. And the money came from everywhere. To help right a wrong from the past, that's something many people would help with. I donated to it myself, if only to ease my pain. I wonder what those who died and are watching from the spiritual world, what they would think of the work done here. Would you know my name if you saw me from heaven? Would I know the same if I saw you in heaven? I must be strong and carry on, 'cause I know I don't belong here in heaven. Would you take my heaven.